Hello children, very interesting lesson I am going to start today, that is prehistoric society. You are very interested to hear, no children, when Earth started, what were the elements were there in the soon after evolution of the Earth, and all you are very interested to see, no? So that one only I am going to start today. That lesson name is prehistoric society. See children, from nearly 4600 million years ago Earth started. From that period to today, the period what we are calling as the history period, it is divided into three stages, three periods you can say. That one I wrote on the board, prehistoric period, protohistoric period and historic period. Like I said, in three periods they are, the period of the time is divided. How they divided this one, on what basis they divided this one? They taken the base as a written script. History is written or no? So, on the basis of written script only, the period is divided into three parts. Okay? So, now we will know the meaning of these three. First one is prehistoric period. Prehistoric period means it is the just evolution, soon after the evolution of the man. Stone Age. Do you heard about Stone Age? That one, children. Stone Age also it is called. See, in this age, man lived in the jungle. He is not ever having any civilization. As an animal only, he lived in the jungle. That one, again we are learning. That time, in detail, I will explain that one. First, you know the meaning of prehistoric period. In this period, man lived in the jungle as an animal. Followed, children? Yes. And in that time, we are not getting any source of history. Somewhere, some sources are there. Skeleton of the man, what stone weapons they are used, that one we are getting. But they are not sufficient to understand them. Only we know that he lived in the jungle. Because some caves we got, some stone weapons, wooden weapons we got, skeleton of the man we got. Because of these sources, we understood that man lived in the jungle. But there is no any written script in that. To understand their lifestyle about them means there is no script. Because of that one, it is called as a prehistoric, before history, prehistory means. And it is usually called as a stone age. Because man don't know anything. He used, with the stone only used to make the weapons. And he is living in the rocks. So it is called as a stone age. Followed? Next comes protohistoric period. Protohistoric period means man is somewhat is a civilized person. As we are, how we are not like that, only man lived the civilized life. Civilized means what, children? In the society. Wearing clothes, building the houses and all, doing business and all, wearing ornaments. Cooked food, eating, all this one is called civilization. In that period, in the protohistoric period, man lived in a civilized life. But what happened to them? Written scripts are there. Written history is there. But we are not able to understand that one. So, for example, for this is Harappa civilization. Harappan civilization. You might have heard this one, children. Harappa civilization. See, these Harappa people are very much civilized like us. They build the building like us only. They are using ornaments. They are having trade with the foreign countries. Well, land, the towns they are having. And printed seals are there. Trade seals are there. Written script is there. But till today, we are unable to read them. So, what script is available, it is not sufficient for us to understand their life. What sources we are getting, ornaments we are getting, some seeds we are getting, some cloth pieces we are getting. By that one, just we are imagining their civilization. Some town brandages and all we got, bathroom we got, tank we got. By that one, we are understood that these are civilized people who lived in that time. They are civilized people, only that much we know. But what they wrote, we are unable to read. Because of this reason, it is called as a protohistoric period. Follow children meaning? Next comes historic period. At present, what we are living now? That one. We are having sufficient sources to learn the understand the history. Many history books are there, children. Many kingdoms we are learning. Before that, what was the condition of the human being? All that one. Written history is there. It is sufficient and we are able to read that one. So, it is called as a historic period. Follow, children. Prehistoric period means it is a stone age. That time there is no written script. Man lived in the jungle, it is called as a stone age. What it is? Second one, proto-historic period. Man is a civilization, he lived in the society. Written script is also there, but we are unable to read it. So, it is called proto-historic period. Example for this is Harappa civilization. Next, historic period means what we are living on that one, present period of this. In this period, we are having sufficient source of history. Many history books are there, monuments are there, written scripts are there, and we are able to read the history. So, it is called as the historic period. Like this way, history period is divided into three parts of the. Now, very curious matter, when earth evolved, how man came to the earth. Before man, what were the animals, bacteria were there? That one I am going to explain with the chart in the tail of this one. Okay. See children, earth born nearly 4600 million years ago it is. See, when earth evolved, no? That time only single cell bacteria were there in the earth. They are called prokaryotes. You have to take the knowledge to the prokaryotes. They are called single cell only bacteria. So, how the year time go on passing? That time one by one animals, birds, insects they started. I will explain this one with the chart. See children, stages of evolution among the organism and plants. See, years I wrote here, all are in millions. Here, organism, which birds, insects, animals started, not that one. Here I wrote the plants. See children, this period is before BC it is. Before BC, how we used to write that year? First, the starting year, then ending one we have to write, reverse it is. So, microorganism, that means bacteria, which one we can't see from the naked eyes. Such a bacteria and organism, they started 2500 million years ago. Up to 4000 million years back, only microorganisms were there. And in the plants, lichens were there. Pache and all you can see children, on the rocks and all it is. Greenery you can see on the tree and on the rock. That is called lichens. Next, see, 5070 years back, molluscs, they started children. And algae started. They are near up to 5570 years to 2500 years only they were there. Then, molluscs means snail children, Shankhula in Kannada, that one started. Next, in the 500 to 5 million years back, fishes started, aquatic animals, fish started. Next, 408 million years back to 438 years, insects started children, small insects, grasshopper and all, can you see that one, they started. Along with that, plants on the earth started. These lichens means only greenery in the rock and the tree. Algae means pache children, that started. And afterwards, small plants. Plants means understand, no? Not tree, plant with a small, soft stem. Small height also very less one, that one. They started on the earth. Then, 360 million years ago, that time, amphibians started children. Amphibians means which live both on water as well as on the land. For example, frog, tortoise, all this one. And in the plants, ferns started.
algae also was there. Ferns means it is a small stem with a short long stem with a feathery leaves children. You might have seen this one in the grass, you can find this one. Stem is very soft one, little bit length will be there for the plant. Leaves are very small one, like a feather it looks. In the grass usually you will find this one in the open places children. Next, 248 million years ago, reptiles started. Reptiles means which move from the stomach. For example, snake children, snake, tortoise, crocodile, all these were reptiles they are called. They started. Next, nearly 230 million years ago, dinosaurs started. Very big animals, dinosaurs. They are looked like a crocodiles only, very big one. Dinosaurs started, only they were there. When they demolished, they gone not children. Then many types of birds and animals evolution started. That is, from 144 million years ago, birds and mammals started children. Birds means they will lay the egg. Mammals means they are giving the birth to the young ones. Small ones started. Small one who? Rabbit, cat, dogs. Small one who are giving the birth to the young one. Followed no children? All animals, they are not giving the birth to their young ones. Birds, they are laying the eggs. Yes or no? Snake is also giving the eggs. Mammals means which is giving the birth to their young ones. They are giving birth to the babies. For example, rat is there, cat is there, dog, that one, small one. Next, children, 65 million years ago, the flowers started. Flowering plants, only small stems were there, pachy, algae was there, ferns were there, but the flowering plants were not there. That one started. Next, 38 million years ago, bigger mammals started, children. Here, small one, I given the example of rat, cat, dog, children. Here, bigger one started. For example, animal, the elephant. Then, tiger, giraffe. Like this, big mammal started. And on the grass, on the earth, grass is also started growing. Before that, grass also was not there, children. After the big mammals, nearly 5 million years ago, apes started. Apes means you can say gorilla children. From the apes only man developed. Manganinda manava. Do you heard the word? So apes means that one only. From the apes only man developed. Then in the 5 million years ago only, these apes only developed as a bipeds. Means they are using only, apes means four, all the four hands only they are using as a for walking purpose only. This biped means two they are used as a leg and two as a hands. Followed na children? They are called bipeds. Next, 1.8 million ago, human beings started. Human being developed from the beeps only they developed. I will stick the chart children from the apes how man came no? That picture I will stick to this video. Watch it. Okay. I think you understood the chart.
Yes, see children, from the apes, man developed, that is nearly 1.8 million years back. Man started, man evolved, man originated. Suddenly he came, from the apes he not considered how to use the hands, how to use the weapons and all. One by one he learned, however the days passed. So when the man we got know, that one, that period is called as the historic period or stone age. Stone age it is called. So what the historians, what they are telling, when this man got know, first time he born in Africa. So Africa is called as the birthplace of human beings. Where the man evaluated now, first time man evaluated in Africa continent. So Africa is called as a birthplace of human beings children. So whatever the skeletons, how the man was there, when he evolved, all that one they are available in Africa continent. So
some historians they are calling Africa as the birthplace of human beings. For a children, when he born, he lived in a jungle only. He don't know anything about the civilization life. As a animal only, he lived in the jungle. That period is called historic period. Again, it is divided into three periods. However, his bone developing was again. This period is divided into three parts. That one we will take in the next class today. So for today session, you understand only this much today. Okay. Now for today's session, take the homework. Yes, three questions I wrote down. When was the earth born? How many years back it was? That's right. Which are the three main stages of history? Just I explained, no? History is divided into three. That means that's right. When was man evolved? When man evolved, no? That year we had to write. 1.8 million years ago, man evolved. Follow up, children? Yes. Enough for today. Next class, I am taking the Stone Age, prehistoric period, and it is divided into three parts. That one I am going to